She's returned, Geralt. After all these years.
The man who meets the hunt returns to this world. I returned.
Okay, welcome back, my friends. We're back here with a little more Witcher 3 Wild Hunt action. And right now, we are in the, we're in the Baron's Fortress. I don't really know what it's called. It's just his fortress, right? And it's a pretty prominent, pretty expansive structure. It sits prominently up on this hill, surrounded by water. You know, it's definitely a stronghold. Anyway, we just got finished, questioning Gretka as pleasantly as we possibly could about Ciri. About her time spent with Ciri. We've searched Ciri's room. We've gotten as much information as I possibly can. On my own, I need the Baron's help from this point forward, and the only way I'm getting that is to find his wife and child. And so currently, that's what we're doing. Family matters. Talk to the Baron about what I've found thus far in his wife's chamber. You know, there was definitely some sort of a scuffle. And the evidence of such a thing seemed to have been tucked away into the shadows.
Don't poking around.
I found a doll in your child's room. Seemed like it had something to do with voodoo or black magic.
Found
explain
a doll
yourself.
In Tamara's room. Tell me about it.
What could possibly be so interesting about a doll, Witcher?
Looks like it might have been used for some sort of black magic. Where'd Tamara get it?
Black magic? Are you barmy? I made it for her. She was four, perhaps five winters old. We were in Vizima on market day, and she saw the sorceress, Triss Merigold. Insisted she must have a doll just like her. Couldn't afford a thing of that sort, so I made the doll with me own hands.
You're looking a little foolish now, aren't you, Witcher? As I recall, Triss looks much different, and trust me, I know, yes. Yes, I know exactly what she looks like, inside and out.
Triss. No offense, but, not great with your hands, are you?
Why don't you take some wooden rags, see what image of a grown woman you can come up with?
Girl insults him. The fact that he took insult to that. Well, the fact that I insulted the man's work, doll crafting abilities, well. Anyway, there were signs. Well, no, let's ask about the amulet first. I don't know if I should get into the whole fight thing just yet.
Recognize this amulet?
Yes. Anna began wearing it a time ago.
Any idea where she got it?
None.
Any witches or cunning women in the area?
A Pella. Old Coot lives near Blackbow. And there's a cunning woman in Midcops, but I know little about her. She's only recently arrived. If Anna were to see someone, she'd choose the Pella, not the woman. Anna was wary of strangers, newcomers.
All right. I'm off to see the Pella, then.
I want to have a chat with this Peller.
Fair warning, he's a hard man to talk to. Rumor has it he killed his own father with an axe as a lad, then went batty. Now they say he sees ghosts and plows his goat.
Not really interested in his hobbies, just want to ask.
He plows his goat? That's terrible. Damn evil goat probably has a good plowing coming, doesn't he? Yes, he does. Anyway. I don't know what a Peller is. I don't know. I get the idea like he's maybe like some, I don't know, some reclusive wise men or, I don't know. An herbsman or something? I can't say. Till I meet up with the man and gain some sort of an impression on him. Probably best we didn't mention the fight to the Baron. We want to get him all worked up and worried. More so than he already is. I fear the worst for these two women, though, if I'm being honest. God damn it, what is it? 2 o'clock in the morning? We're gonna travel in this pissing down rain? I think not. Middle of the night? No. I refuse. We're going back inside where it's dry, and I'm gonna meditate. Don't mind me, gentlemen. Hey! Don't you want to start something with me? I promise you, I will finish it. The end of my blade. What do we have going on in here? What is this? I wonder if I can upgrade my gear here. No, it doesn't look like it. Well, this is clearly the guards' quarters. I just want to find a nice warm fire I can curl up next to. The Baron. Baron, keep an eye on me. Your guards, they're issuing death threats. I need to meditate before I set off. Don't mind me. Alright. Hopefully, I'll tell you, this rain had better subside. Come dawn. Oh! Did I need to use that? Oh, damn it. That becomes real annoying, you know? I wish it would just do it when I wanted it to do it, and not just at every time I decide I want to take a little time and relax. Bloomin' hell. Anyway, still raining. God damn it. Still raining. At least we're not wandering through the darkness. I guess I can put that away at this point. And I wonder if the alkalest filled up my bombs as well. That's quite possible. Let's have a look. Yeah, that's precisely what it was spent on. I don't know if we're my... Did you call me a prick, sir? Perhaps I will... Cut yours off! Keep your mouth shut. Alright, there's no love lost between you and these henchmen. No. No, Geralt, there isn't. Alright, let's grab Roachy. Actually, no. Where is Roach? I'm surprised they let the wild horse just run the length of the bridge and make his way in here. Alright, I'm definitely going to have to figure out where it is we're heading and how far. Okay, that's not bad. That's right, he mentioned Blackbow, didn't he? Or Blackbow. And I got confirmation on what the city's actually called. Because the Baron himself mentioned it in his mad ramblings, yes. Oh, we've got a notice board here. Maybe I should look into doing a little work. One thing at a time, though, Witcher. You've got enough on your plate currently. Oh, now, careful here, Roachy. Watch out for the kickback on these blooming doors. Are you kidding me? I can't get through there. There we go. Maybe we're gonna have to go ass end first. I don't know. There you go. I swear he wouldn't move when I first approached him. Anyway, put it behind you here, Witcher. Put it behind you, sir. And you know what? Before I leave town. Let's have words with the trader here.
Spot of cider for you? Or a bit of dry curd?
Nice, he's got some food.
Burst him, but what I got sure to please.
Okay. It's gonna be a game of Gwent here first, sir.
How about a few rounds of cards?
I'd love specifically. I'd love a real life clear weather card. That's what I bloody well need, yes. Okay. Now, let's see here. Oh, that's right. Here we go. The fork tail for the monsters. Let's get that in there. Why would Zoltan be able to get into the monster's deck? Because he's a true beast of a man. Yes. Beast of a dwarf. I don't know. Yes. All right. That should do. Start her up. Oh, Northern Realms on Northern Realms. What are we dealing with here? Did I draw a card there accidentally? I'm not sure what happened. You know what? I may actually hold on to both of these guys. I'm not too disappointed with that draw. The only reason I'm gonna hold on to both of them. No, you know what? I'm gonna get rid of one of them. Oh, terrible exchange. You know, the only card in the deck that could have made matters worse, that I could have drawn that was worse than that one. Oh, well, we'll have a great standoff here. Poor fucking infantry. Against poor fucking infantry. Who will reign supreme on the front lines of this war? Oh, he even brings out this fella, this guy that I refuse to put into my deck that I have. I have the card for him. I just don't want him in there. Alright. Well, let's play this game then. I'll match you here and prepare to bring out my catapult or trebuchet. Oh, he's matching you here, Geralt. He's matching you. He knows what you're up to and he could be planning some wily counterattack. We'll see. We'll see. Trebuchet down. Oh, and he did! Oh, and he came out stronger. He did it better and faster than you, sir. Better and faster. Well, I could potentially shut him down here with a little rain. In fact, you know what? I think I'll do that. Even the playing field out. He's got a slight lead. Will he pass? He did, foolishly. You've much to learn, good sir. Much to learn indeed. Alright, well, who knows what he's holding back? He could have some real strength back there, but I'm feeling good at this point. Alright, a little fog coming into my possession, which is good, because I got rid of my last mid-range character card. Alright, out you get there, Zoltan. Out you get, sir. Alright. Get the medic out, and bring back in my trebuchet. More of an engineer, you know. Come on. What the hell? There we go. I guess spacebar is the best way to activate the card. Rather than trying to do the double click, which seems to deny me more often than it permits me, you know. The selection. Alright, and there we go. A second trebuchet enters the battlefield. This is a Crinford Reavers hunter card or something. And let's shut him right down with a little fog. Loving it. I dare you to drop some rain, sir. I'm waiting for it, in fact. Alright, and I'm gonna pass. I'm gonna hold on to Vest just in case he does something a bloody miraculous here to take the lead. No, he couldn't pull it off. He didn't have enough tricks up his sleeve. He did not. Alright, wonderful. I'll take the money. I'll take the Griffin. Nice, another monster
Spot
card coming
a cider
in.
For you? Or a bit of dry curd? Me lad, it's not exactly bursting, but what I got sure to please.
Definitely take a look and see what he has.
Like to take a look.
Okay. Oh, he's got some cards here. Are they all Nilfgaardian? Yeah, they are by the looks of things. I could spend a little cash and start feeding that deck. Okay, Mandrake Cordial. Cherry Cordial, nice. Nice. What's this cost to me? Oh my. I think I'm gonna grab four of these suckers. And I'm going to grab the saddlebags. Probably a good choice. How long is this going to last me? 5 seconds a pop. That's going to do 5 seconds a pop as well. I guess we're eating onions currently, which... Well, he's got a taste for the onions. You know? That's fine. Alright. Just to have it as some sort of a backup. Case in some, you know, some truly daunting...
Farewell.
Battle against, you know, a truly formidable foe. I burned through my swallows and I need to resort to a little food eating, you know.
That's it,
at least
Roach.
I'll have something. Okay. Alright, and we're finally setting off here. Now, what are we looking for? The pillar. He's a true pillar of the community, yes. Not really, he sounds like a real heathen, this fella. Killed his old man with an axe when he was nothing but a lad and then went mad! Oh no. Looking for his hut. So yeah, you know what, I think I may have the right impression of him. Kinda like this old, you know, maybe like a monk. Reclusive monk or something like that, you know. Knowledgeable about certain matters that most don't dare dabble in. Yes. Who's to say? I need to watch out. We've got bandits roaming the grounds around here somewhere, don't we? On horseback, in fact. I'll tell you, this rain, it's been said before in this series and others. It really puts me in a foul mood. Really chaps my ass, it does. Alright, now what are we passing through? Is this Black Bow? Black Bow. Now that I've heard it mentioned, I can't actually spit it out properly. Alright, I think that's that little hut. That's the house where I battled that collection of, like, I don't know what it was, like 6 or 7 bandits were stationed there when I was traveling from Heatherton towards Midcops. Alright, what are we dealing with here? Perhaps some toll takers, I don't know. Some highwaymen of sorts. I won't take your bridge then, gentlemen, no. I'll find passage elsewhere. Passage through the wilds of this wonderful land. Alright, here we go. Roach, keep a safe distance, please. Now what's happening here? The Baron's got a large collection of men here. Sounds like they're trying to get into the house.
What do you want?
Want to talk to the Peller.
Too late. We've got dibs on a chat with him. A long one.
Oh no. What do you want from the Peller exactly?
What do you want from him?
To give him what he deserves.
And that is?
He done conjured Alkaries. Said something evil had made its nest in Edric's bowels. Told Edric to eat rowan berries. Lots of them.
Ever since Edric's lived in the outhouse. And he's got rotten pustules all over him.
I'll tell you what. You leave and I'll heal poor Edric.
Just so happens I need the Peller alive. So if you agree to leave him alone, for good, I'm willing to tell you how to help Edric.
Well, all in all...
Yes or no?
Fine. Let's hear it.
Good.
A tea of mullein leaves for his belly, and cover his boils with mallow. A few days and he'll be good as new.
Noted. But if it don't work, we'll be back. Move out, boys.
I was thinking about getting into a scrap with him, but, you know... We're here on the Baron's behalf. I don't want to be slaying his men, unruly or not.
Gotta wonder about a man who could get Edric's friends all worked up.
Alright. Let's go and deal with this Peller.
Hey, anybody home? Open up, it's safe now.
Devils. Who do they bring? What seek ye?
I need your help.
Whoa, a man. Nay, a wolf. Grey, though not old. 'Tis he the Peller awaits.
What's he got on him? Are chicken claws or something? I don't know. Something like that. Chicken feet strapped to the front of his clothes. You were expecting me, were you?
You were expecting me.
Aye, as the bones declared I should. They shall come whose stench is rape and death, but the wolf shall disperse them, the white wolf. And thus he comes. Omens never lie.
So he's like a mystic, and a damn good one at that, I must admit. I need your help, sir.
Recognize this? made of spruce wood, strong smell of juniper, designed to protect someone.
Freshly cut spruce, sprinkled with goat's blood, then tempered with an incense of earth, smoke, and juniper. For Anna, to protect her.
From what exactly, sir?
So, designed to protect her. From what?
Oh, the besieged she was, evil all around, wanting to possess her. Old magic, born of oblivion, from dark sources emerged.
Old magic? Can you be more specific?
Tis not for mouth speech, nor for the touch. A small protective charm, not a thing more Appella could do.
Anna and her daughter are missing. Know where they are?
Nay. Pella don't know. But the spirits could know. The Pella will augur, the spirits ask.
Spirits? Great. Fine with me. Long as I know where to look, where to find them.
Lost. Must be found. Princess! None better than princess for finding things.
Princess? Which princess?
Princess, my goat! She's fled!
No. The evil goat that he likes to plow.
Can we get back to the auguring?
Without the goat, impossible. No goat, won't work.
No! I gotta go find this damn goat. Fine.
Will you help me if I bring the goat back?
Princess! Princess! Where have you got to, girl?
Fine. I'll get your goat.
The bell. The little bell's ringing. She loves it. Ring, ring, and she will follow. But for a while.
Oh my god.
But beware,
it's like an endless supply of
strawberries. Raspberries, too.
Yeah. Treacherous as beasts go. I always keep an eye out for them.
All right. We've got Peller's Bell. Peller's Bell. All right. You have a new quest item. Prepare it for use by placing it in an appropriate slot. Yes. Good. Now, we're probably going to find the goat. The way things are going here, it's the Baron wants us to find this, the Peller wants us and sends us to the Peller. The Peller wants us to find this and sends us to the goat. The goat was probably going to want us to find some pet mouse events before it's going to help us and come back to the Peller. Oh my god, it's ridiculous. Anyway, that's fine though, I'm kind of enjoying it. Now what I want to do, I want to get that quest item in. It was not the talisman. Now, where the hell is it? I was given something. Now, do I have to do something with... I must have to do something with these saddlebags. I just don't know what. Now, hold on a second. Where is this damn... Oh, it's right there. It's already in there. Okay. Stupid. Now, why would it do it automatically and then tell me to do it myself? Anyway. Alright. Okay, find the Peller's goat using the bell and my witcher's senses. Yes. But of course.
This way, I think.
Fell goat.
Another clue.
The goat is probably possessed by some sort of evil spirit. We'll have to be put down, which we'll put a smile on Hertzie's face. Putting down this evil goat. That old Peller likes to plow. On a nightly basis, yes, he curls up with his... Oh, what do we have coming in here? Some wolves, apparently, by the sounds of things. They could have the goats around it, in fact. Be at your best here, I betcha. You're done, Wolfie. I'll tell you, is that ever a change of pace after doing battle as Ciri against the wolves, you know? Quite different. Quite a different vibe. Alright. Ding Lang Lang, where are you, Goatee? What's the goat's name, in fact? Oh, what's this now? Oh, I hear it! Where is it? There's something. Oh, that must be it. That must be it. Now, what is this here? Honeysuckle. Good. Alright, this works out quite well.
There you are.
Oh, princess. That's the goat's name. What's it
here,
doing?
Goat. Here, princess.
There we go. Warned.
Should have known it would be stubborn.
Alright, is that it? Is it following me now?
All
come
right.
on, Goaty.
Time to try the bell. Come on, let's go see the belly.
Ridiculous.
Should have guessed as much. What's a witcher compared to a patch of wild strawberries?
Did I lose it? Oh, damn it, I lost it.
Come on.
Come on.
Get back to the pillar.
Let me pick
this
all these strawberries.
Awful.
There we go. Need to try and avoid these strawberries. Oh, there's another one right here. I'd better pick it clean.
Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow? This way, Your Grace.
Witcher get losing his patience here. Now keep your cool here, Vetcher. It's gonna be a matter of just bringing back the goat's head. Come on, princess.
Where the hell did you go?
Oh, this is ridiculous. Oh my god. Stubborn little thing, isn't it? Now,
bear,
what's happening here?
Bear,
oh no.
Run, you stupid.
Oh no.
Shit.
Oh, dang. I'll tell you, this thing is big and burly. And put a little fear in me, in fact, yes. Loving it. Deal with it, bear. Deal with it. Oh, and you're done. No match for the great white wolf. Alright, oh. This bear is a man killer. Or a woman killer, in fact, yes. Alright, I don't know where the goat's at. I hear him. Oh, princess down there. I guess it is a she, since Peller likes to plow her. Alright, I wonder if there's anything in the bear cave. There's definitely some loot to be had here. A little fat. Take it. Alright, what am I working with here? Oh my. What is down in here? Quick saving it. This could be worth exploring. I don't know if I should be doing it right now. Maybe I should get the goat back first. Okay, there's nothing in there. I have a feeling whatever's down here is probably like Necker's or something like that. You know there's gonna be something good down here. Alright, I'm gonna drop the goat off first. We'll get the goat back. Ding-a-lang-lang there, princess.
This bell for you to follow.
Alright, now, what I want to do before I set off from here is just... Is this marked in any way? I want to get a marker on there. Alright, now no more hiccups here, princess. Just follow me back, please. She coming? It would appear as though yes, she is. Good. Alright, excellent. Mission complete. Nice little battle there with the bear. Good time. Good time!
Dearest, sweetest goat.
Mr. Raspberry Jam. Oh. Anyway, ridiculous. Will you help me now, sir?
Happy for you, but I'm kinda in a hurry. Anna and Tamara, they might be in danger.
The White Wolf helped the Pella, and so the Pella shall help him. Blood. We need blood. A living being.
I like how he refers to himself in the third person, you know? The Pella will help you now,
right?
Yes.
Back.
Need blood from a... Did he say from a human being? Really? Now don't get all kinky with the goat before I return. I don't want to walk... Oh, damn. What are you doing, sir? Good lord.
Will
anyway.
This do?
I know, I'm filthy. I'm filthy! Goat's milk and blood. Oh, I don't know what I retrieved for him. Oh, rat. Dead rat. Alright. It's all really, you know, well done. I like all the pieces of this puzzle slowly. Of this mission playing out. You know. Tracking down the goat was a little ridiculous, but it's, pretty good done. Oh, dang.
I see blood.
Whose?
No one. No Tamara. Just the child.
Contact was clearly made.
That lives not, yet did not die.
Oh no. Whose?
Mentioned a child. Whose?
Why, Anna's.
Anna was pregnant?
She was, and she miscarried.
Baron didn't mention it.
Afraid, perhaps, or ashamed, or forgetful. Or perhaps he had no wish to remember.
The Baron have anything to do with his wife's miscarriage?
Foul-tempered he is, and he's a fondness for hooch.
No doubt makes his temper even fouler. Did he abuse his family? Anna came to you. You must have noticed something.
The Pella's old, near blind. But Princess came and licked her hand.
So what?
She's a wise beast. Only comes to those who suffer.
The child, what happened to it? What happened to it?
What happened to the child?
In a grave thrown, without rite or ceremony, it awoke. Now it wanders. It seeks vengeance.
A botchling.
Oh no.
White wolf. Wise wolf.
Those things are
catch
ugly.
The botchling. The botchling will help. Lead the wolf to the loved ones.
Botchlings suck the blood of pregnant women and eat their fetuses. They don't help.
Tis a being cursed, and witches lift curses. If the white wolf can't lift it, he should bring me its blood. Blood will always find kindred blood.
Why do you need its blood? I guess is what I should be asking here.
Why do you want its blood?
Blood. 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 It binds men for all ages, the living and the dead.
Sure, but what do you want to do with it?
At times, a century is too short for two brothers to reconcile. One dies before things are set right. The other then brings his blood to the Pella.
And what does the Pella do?
He awaits Forefather's Eve. He mixes the blood with milk, herbs, and hen's feet. He drinks to reconcile the dead with the living. There shall be no Forefather's Eve this year, but we'll find a way, all the same.
How can I lift this curse, Peller?
Heard of one witcher who lifted a botchling's curse. Never tried it myself, though. I know you need to bury it under the threshold.
And give it a name. Perform the I'm Roin.
The ritual of naming? That's an elven custom.
Human, elven, dwarven, ancient. Spirits have no race. They honor not its meaning. Win a spirit's favor, and the spirit shall aid you. Ask, and it will answer. Seek, and it will show you the way.
Very well. I need to know where this botchling is located, Peller.
Whatever I do, I gotta find the botchling first.
Seek it at midnight, near the grave that lies empty.
If what you say is true, the Baron ought to know where that grave is.
Okay. Read the bestiary to learn more about botchlings. Good, good. And that's going to lead me to eventually have to talk to the Baron. In fact, you know, I think I could probably just head over and talk to the Baron. What I want to do, probably with the tail end of this episode, the little time we've got left, is head back to this cave and do a little inspection here. See what kind of treasure lies lost and forgotten in its belly. Little respect for the dead there, Geralt. Just walking right over the thing. Over the body. Okay. I guess I can... Okay, I've lost the bell, thankfully. Or it's come out of my hotkey list. Alright, we're definitely going to get a quick save in. And let's go exploring. See what we can find down here. Alright, is it ever just pitch black down here? Oh my god. Nice! A greater runestone. That's a decent find. I'll tell you, we've got something in here. It just feels like it's just waiting to pounce. Unless all of this is topside. It may very well be, in fact. Oh nice, look at this. The Ursine Steel Sword. Mastercrafted Witcher gear. Loving it. And a meteorite silver ingot and a little timber. I guess that's it. Ah, I was hoping to be doing some battling down here. That's fine, though. Alright, Roachie, where you at? Let's take a quick look. I might as well go in and read up on... What was it? The botchling. Cursed ones? Yeah. Now, we've seen the card for this thing in that one game of Gwent. Oh my god. Saying a botchling's ugly is like saying shit's not particularly tasty. Can't say it's a lie, but it doesn't exactly convey the whole truth either. From Lambert of Witcher of the Wolf School. Botchlings are perhaps the most repulsive creatures a Witcher will ever have the displeasure of meeting. Born of dead, unwanted babies, discarded without a proper burial, their appearance is that of a partially decayed fetus, their unformed flesh twisted with hate, fear, and malice. These hideous creatures feed on the blood of pregnant women driven by mad hunger that most often leads to their victim's death. Good. Well, not really, no. That's fine, though. Alright. Where's Roachie? I guess we're riding for the Baron at this point. Sort of way, that bitch, huh? Alright. You know, it was a pretty decent collection of missions culminating, you know, driving us. I really do like the way they handle that. You know, whether the Witcher is either working for profit often, or it's kind of it's out of necessity. It's, you know, I scratch my back, or you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours type of deal, you know. Where both parties have something that they want from the other, right? Rather than a mere exchange of gold. The fact we had to go track down a goat, though. Oh, wow. And then it was a stubborn goat with an appetite for, I don't know, what was it? Strawberries or something? Good time. I don't know, I was joking around with the peller, but that was pretty cool, you know. I like going through the ritual and you know, basically summoning the dead. Summoning spirits. Oh, no. Something's happened here. Get the quick save in. Do I enter from the front, or should I maybe take that side bridge? Look at this guy. Not willing to abandon his posting. One of them did, though.
Ever heard of preventive bastard?
Oh, no. Look at these people. Come on, out of the way, unless you want to get trampled by my horse here.
Roach.
All right, we'll leave Roachy alone. We'll go off on foot. Roach seems to have a bit of a difficult time with the doors there. All right, what has happened up here, I wonder? I definitely have a sense of urgency, you know. The alarm ringing. Surely the Witcher can help out here.
Oswin? Where's Oswin? Anyone seen him?
I believe I saw him heading to the stable.
What?
Fire. You blind? Nobody willing to put it out?
Ain't that simple. Most are afraid. Baron flies into a rage. He takes no prisoners.
My brother's in the stable. We've got to save him. He'll burn alive. Him and the horses.
See what I can do.
Hurry now, quick!
Well, despite the man looking to profit, we're not going to sit back and watch some poor man here burn to death. What's happening here with the Baron?
You, where do I know you from, eh?
Oh, he probably set the bloody blaze himself. He's drunk as a skunk.
The Witcher! Come, drink with me. Pale as a ghost you are.
I know your wife miscarried. Was that before or after you beat her to a pulp?
Fuck are you suggesting?
Don't play me for a fool. You'd been beating them for years. Finally, they'd had enough and fled. Sound about right?
Oh no.
They ran from you, didn't they?
Lying prick!
Oh no, I can't even get any of the... Oh damn, I'm so beat here. Oh, I've lost this bloody fight. That's for damn sure. I didn't realize I couldn't drink the swallow. It's gonna be one hell of a comeback with a sliver of health. No, damn it. And I was hitting the wrong button to block. I was trying to evade. It wasn't doing it right. Alright. Well, let's load up the most recent save then. Did I get a quick save in there? There may have been an autosave that come in. You know, I think I'm going to leave the Baron and try and save this guy's brother or whatever, his friend, that disappeared into the flaming barn there, or whatever it is, the stable. No. I'm forced to deal with the Baron. Baron swinging for the fences, oh my. Dawn, Baron. We blocked it. Oh, nice. I got a counterattack in there. And down you go, you bloody bastard, you. I guess so much for saving this man. Damn it.
We need to talk.
Burning alive in there. Bloody hell.
Sit down.
I'll tell you, that sobered him up, didn't it?
I never laid a finger on Tamara. Not once.
And on Anna?
That's another story.
Mm-hmm. Killed his wife.
She always knew how to spark my ire.
Killed his wife, and I would imagine his daughter saw it and fled.
Your wife? How'd she make you angry? Too much salt in the soup? Socks never darned?
20 years we've known each other. She's seen me drunk and sober. She was there to greet me when I returned the victor. She was there to patch me up in defeat. Like no other, she knew where to press, where to pinch, so it would hurt.
You beat her? For that? For criticizing you?
Oh, Witcher, you haven't a clue, have you? Well, perhaps I shall tell you about it one day. One day, but not today.
And so you knew they ran away and had me jumping through these hoops nonetheless.
You knew they had run away from the start.
Yes, I knew.
Why didn't you tell me? Wasted my time.
Say I had. Say I'd said I had troubles. Couldn't control my wife, my daughter. What kind of flaccid prick would you take me for?
I thought maybe he had killed her and, you know, like I said, and then Tamara fled. But no, it sounds like Anna took off with their daughter, right? And they didn't run away, sir. You drove them out. What with your anger, your temper, and your drinking, clearly.
Gotta admit, I do think you're a prick. Not because you couldn't control them, but because you drove them away.
What?
Don't play the idiot. You gave them no choice.
Anna and I. It wasn't as it seemed. Seems.
So tell me how it really was then, sir. Explain yourself. And save a little face here at the tail end of this episode.
All right, I'm all ears. Tell me what happened. The truth this time.
I'd been soaking myself 3 days straight. Anna came to me, said they were leaving. I begged them to stay. She refused to hear it. I tried to stop her. She wriggled like an eel. We struggled. She fell. Last blasted thing I remember. Woke up in the morn, breeches heavy with my own piss. A large bump on my head. Sadly, they were gone. Know what that's like, Witcher? No. How the fuck could you? I was left with nothing. Nothing! Only the bottle.
What happened next?
Next? It only got worse. I awoke at sunset, not knowing how many days had passed. Thought it was all a ploughing, drunken nightmare. And then I went to the bedchamber, but Anna was not there. Instead, there was blood everywhere. I knew she'd miscarried. My breath short, my throat locked. I neared the bed and saw it. It lay there, a tiny thing, defenseless, on bloodied sheets, dead. And it was my doing.
Damn. What'd you do with the, No, it must have been a horrible sight, sir. And a true weight must have settled itself upon your shoulders.
Seen a lot of dead in my time, but that must have been hard.
Unspeakably so. My legs gave out. I saw fields of corpses at Sodden. Saw witches burn in Maribor. But compared to this, all that was a rabbit's prick alongside a great oak. And the guilt is all mine.
We don't know that yet. The amulet Anna wore could be linked somehow. Maybe the fact that she lost it. What did you do with the child?
Wrapped it in a clean sheet and buried it.
Just like that?
Damn you! I gave no thought to a funeral. It was a horror. I wanted it to end. That child had been my dream. I told Anna, the little one, our little one, to make things right. Yet she died before she could be born. Understand, Witcher. My child was dead.
I sympathize. I do.
Thank you.
And know that I hope you find your Ciri.
Deal we made means I need to find Tamara and Anna first. Just so happens your unborn daughter might help us do that.
What? How?
Sometimes miscarried fetuses, if they don't get a proper burial, turn into botchlings.
Into fucking what?
You don't want to know.
Details you don't need to know. There's a bond of blood between this creature and your wife and daughter. I can use that bond to find them.
How?
One of two ways. Legends claim you can bury a botchling under the family's threshold, perform a ritual, and turn it into a lubberkin. That's a sort of, hob, a guardian spirit that could lead me to your family.
And the other way?
We kill it and draw some blood. Take that to the Peller and he does the rest.
Do not kill my child. It's suffered enough already. Lift the curse that it may finally rest in peace.
I haven't quite decided, sir, but I will take your counsel into consideration, yes.
Still not sure what to do.
Whatever you decide, we must put an end to my child's suffering.
Well then, waste no more time, sir. Where'd you bury the fetus?
Whatever we do, we gotta find the botchling first.
I'll show you where I buried her, and I'll dig the grave at my threshold.
If it turns out we can't transform the botchling into a lubberkin, they can bury us in it. Handy either way.
I'll come get you soon, sir, I promise.
Need to tend to something first.
Be quick. And me? What am I to do in the meantime?
Sober up.
That's right. Alright, my friends, I think that's it. We're pushing like 50. We're over 50 here at this point. Which is why I decided we'd take a second here, catch your breath, and break for this episode, and pick things up next time when we go hunting a botchling, you know? I don't know, I'd really like to do a little combat with it, but it would make sense to take the Baron's wishes into account, and maybe not slay it, not do battle with it, and rather try and lift the curse. We'll see what happens. I think I'd like to lift the curse, but I do want to get into some good combat with it. I'm sure there'll be plenty more botchlings out there in the game world to kill in good time. Again, appreciate you stopping on in. I hope you had a good time. I hope to see y'all next time. And, of course, and as always, until then, remember why it hurts. Later, all.